Hey guys, how's it going? I hope you're all doing really well out there today. It's been a while since we've taken a look at a self-hosted dashboard to keep track of the services we're running and that sort of thing. So when I was looking for a new project to share with you guys, I was actually kind of excited to see a new dashboard pop up in the self-hosted community. And in today's video, we're going to take a look at a new service called Dashlit. So I guess to just jump right into this, let's go over to my desktop where we can take a look at the Dashlit homepage here. And like it says, Dashlit personal homepage, a simple solution for self-hosting your homepage. And then we've got some links about getting started, live demo, viewing on GitHub, a little icon up here, and then kind of 8 bullet points sort of. This has privacy, offers secure authentication, themes, enjoy a light or a dark theme, your choice, grouping, so you can group services together, an easy setup that doesn't require any kind of YAML file editing. I was really excited to see this as I was going through. We've got a drag and drop interface to rearrange not only services, but groups. We're going to deploy this via Docker. It's free, it's open source, and if you're on your mobile phone or whatever, you can actually install this to your desktop. Maybe there's other ways to do that on like a PC desktop, but I haven't actually explored that yet. If we scroll down a little farther, we've got some screenshots for light mode and dark mode here that you can see. Just a clean, simple interface, and I'm always a big fan of simple apps that do things really, really well. And if we scroll down a little farther, released under the MIT license. Now, before we go any farther into this video, I've got a couple of things that I want to bring up. Yes, this uses Docker. If Docker's not your thing, that's fine. Everybody can do things how they want to, but we primarily focus on Docker on this channel. So again, if Docker's not for you, there's a lot of other great creators out there that you can go check out and learn something new today as well. Another thing is that I'm not the developer of this application. So if you've got questions, if you've got thoughts, if you've got concerns, I would love to hear those, but I can't help you with them because I'm not the developer. I will have links to the website, the GitHub, all of that kind of stuff in the video description. There are already some GitHub issues opened up for like feature requests and that sort of thing. So if there are other things that you would like to bring up to the developer, again, a link for that will be in the video description. And one other quick thing is that this is a very basic dashboard. This is more along the lines of bookmarking, right? This doesn't have API calls, at least at the time of recording this video. This application, this dashboard, is just meant to kind of organize and group URLs, whether it's in your home lab, to your favorite sites, whatever the case is. So you're not going to get API requests to see if a service is up. It's not going to do that. It's not going to pull in information from your favorite service about how many ads you've blocked or how many files you're sharing. It's not going to do any of that. This is a very, very basic dashboard. That's actually kind of what I love about it, is it's dead simple to set up. It does what it says on the tin and nothing more than that. So if you'd like to bring that up with the developer, again, links in the video description, but again, I'm not that guy. So anyway, with that out of the way, let's just move forward with the video and take a look at the little demo instance that I've got set up. And then we'll take a look at how easy this is to get installed. So this is my Dashlit instance that I set up just for the sake of testing this. I don't care if you see the URL, it won't be available by the time this video goes up. So here we can see top left is Dashlit. There's no way to edit that I'm aware of. It just says Dashlit and that's what it is. In the top right corner, we can switch light mode and dark mode, which is great. I know a lot of people like light mode and You're entitled to that. We can also click edit. We can also click log out. Before we do any of those things, though, we're going to take a look down here below. So you can see that I've got two groups of bookmarks basically set up. One for websites with the subtext of public sites that I'm running. There's DB Tech Reviews. There's Homelab Launchpad. That's a new project that I'm getting ready to start deploying some content on a new channel on a new website. I'll have more information down in the video description as well. And then the wiki over here. And then below that, just some different places that you can find me online, whether it's either of the websites associated with the aforementioned other services up here at the top, my Blue Sky, my Twitter, my Facebook. There's other stuff in here, but I think we kind of get, or there's other things that I could put in here, I guess is what I was trying to say, that we could have in here. I just didn't do that because it felt kind of repetitious for the sake of example, right? If we refresh, we can see that like this whole bottom row, all of the icons animate. That is because of third-party icons that we're going to talk about here in a little bit. But, you know, if we click here, it pops it open in a new tab, and that's great. Same thing here, just pops them right open. Love that. You know, like YouTube channel here. Hey, there's DB Tech. Here's the new Homelab Launchpad with almost 400 subscribers. So thank you to everybody who has subscribed to that already. Again, links in the video description if you want to jump on that bandwagon. And then, of course, you know, Blue Sky, the Bird site, Facebook, all of those are in here. And it's all just very, very basic stuff. So if we click edit, immediately the page is going to change. We can see that we can add an additional group. And we can call this a demo. And, you know, I could do something like this and click on add item and call it Dashlit. Let's go with some inception here. We're going to call it dashboard. We'll put in a URL. We can switch this to be either new tab or current tab, whichever you want to do. I usually prefer new tab, so I'm just going to leave that alone. For the show URL, we can show it always, or sorry, never, always, if the description is empty or on hover. So let's go ahead and click on that. Now, this next section is where I get a little bit iffy about this setup process. This requires you to use a third-party solution called Iconify. If we click this open, it brings us over to here, and it's Iconify or icon-sets.iconify.design. Anyway, it doesn't matter. If you come up to here, or if we look here, there's a bunch of different icon sets that you can choose from. Or what I like to do is just do like, let's just type in Facebook, right? And hit enter. And here are all of the different Facebook links or icons that you could use. And I think you may have seen like this one right here, this one animated. So that's the one I used. We could do like Mastodon. I don't know. We'll see. Hey, look at that. There's some more that also animate right over there. If I click search, we can see those reanimate there. So let's just type in dashboard. Whoops. Right. We'll hit enter. Did any of those animate? They did not. Well, then let's just, you know what? Let's grab this one right here. Right down here is the icon name that we're looking for. You can click right here to copy that. We can come back over to Dashlit and just paste that in and click save. And hey, look, there it is. I think, though, if we wanted to, we could change the color. Let's find a bright neon green kind of thing going on there. Click save. And hey, look, now it is that bright neon green instead. So you can adjust the color of the icons if you want to go that route. You know, we can do stuff like this and just drag this down here to the bottom. And now it's there. Let's drag this right up to there. And so we can drag the different groups around. We can drag services or links from one group to another very, very easily without a lot of fuss. And that's it. Like that's how to manage, Dashlit. It's just that simple. Once you're happy with all of that, you click save and there you go. Now, because this is on a domain name, a URL, this dashlit.dbtech, I do have this with a password, right? So if I click log out, hey, look, it wants my password. So I'm going to type that in. And there we go. Just that easily, we're logged back in. I can click edit. I can drag this back down here where it belongs and click save. And all of that edit stuff goes away. So that's how to manage Dashlit. It really is just that easy to create groups, to create links, to add icons, to change their colors, to move things around, whether it's groups or the different services in those groups or the different services from one group to another. Super, super easy to use. And I think at this point, it makes sense to jump over, take a look at their documentation to find out how easy it is to install. So this is the GitHub repository for Dashlit. We can see that it was uploaded a couple of weeks ago, 2 to 3 weeks ago, depending on when the last update was. Some information over here, 129 stars. If you're interested in this project and would like to support it, go ahead and give it a star. It's really that easy. In fact, somebody else did it the exact same time I did, it looks like. We can see releases was a couple of weeks ago. There have been 5 of them so far. Deployments, we got some stuff over there, some languages, more information. Actually, all of the files here, take a look through those so that you're comfortable with what you're deploying on your server. I think that's really important. But below that, we've got more information about Dashlit. We can see the release version, the last commit, the license, the documentation, and the live demo. All of those are available from right here as well. Again, that screenshot that we saw earlier, and then more information about how to get started. Now, again, this is going to be deployed in Docker. So we've got a couple of different Docker Compose options here. If you're just going to keep this local on your home lab and you're never going to expose it to the internet, this one's probably the one you want to use. It's very basic. It's self-explanatory. That's unfair. Let's take a look so that I don't feel like a jerk for having said that. So you got your services. Our first service is the app. You could name this whatever you want to. The container name is Dashlit app. The image is going to pull from the GitHub container repository that is CodeWeck, I'm guessing, / Dashlit with the latest tag on the end. The restart policy of unless stopped. The environment is going to be basically the URL that you're going to access this on. If you've got like Docker desktop, this might be fine. If you're going to have this on a different server, different IP address, you'd put that right here. And then of course the port that you're going to deploy this on. If you're going to put this on a domain name, you would put that whole domain name right there with no ports or anything like that, just HTTPS. You know, dashlit.mysite.com would go right there. Below that, we've got ports. Basically, this is the port that we will use in the browser, this first one. You can change that if you want to, but do not change the one after the colon. If you change that, things will break, the container won't come up. Then we've got our volumes. This is where it's going to store the data for our instance. We would just map this appropriately for wherever we store our Docker container data on our servers. Everyone does that a little bit differently, but you could do like, you know, home Docker or home / Docker / Dashlit / data right here in this little area. And that would work perfectly well. That's typically what I do. Now, if you're going to expose this to the internet, you're going to make this publicly available on the internet for yourself or for whatever. This is where this other one is going to come into play more likely than not. Again, it's going to be very much the same thing. There are just some additional variables in here that we need for authentication. If you try to add a password to this when you're trying to access it on your local network, I've had no luck getting that to work. So I had to put this on a domain name to get it to work for my setup. But for hosting it locally, adding a password and all of that sort of stuff doesn't seem to work at the time of recording this video. So again, you would change this to the domain name that you're accessing this on without the port. And then basically the only thing you would need to change here is the password. Give it a password that you can access this on. Make sure to leave the little dash there in front because of the way this schema is on this Docker Compose. Your secret key, basically change everything from the letter A to the letter H. Leave that little dash in the beginning, but give it a mash of characters so that it can use that for authentication purposes and encrypting your username and your authentication experience. Again, same thing with the ports. We talked about that a moment ago. And then where you want to store the data for this application on your server. Just for the sake of showing you, let's take a look here. This is the Docker Compose, the Docker Compose that I used for my setup. I was doing some testing here, but here we can see the URL. I changed that, but I left the dash there. I didn't change the password because again, this is for demonstrative purposes. This isn't going to be available to you when this video goes up. We've also got this that I changed for the JWT secret. And then I changed this right here because I've just got it in a directory. So if I click exit, we can see that I'm in the Dashlit subdirectory. So if I were to do a PWD for print working directory, here we can see where I am. So it's storing it in this directory. In fact, if I do an ls, here we can see data and data two from some testing that I was doing earlier. Once you're happy with that, you know, we can do, let's do like this, just for the sake of demonstrating here. We'll change that like so. We'll click save and exit, and then we'll clear our screen and do a Docker compose up dash D, just like that. And there we go. So again, if I come back over to here and I refresh, because I was already authenticated, it didn't ask me to authenticate because I didn't change that JWT secret. We can see that there's nothing here because it's a brand new instance in a brand new folder. So it's really just that easy to deploy this with just tweaking the Docker compose a little bit. So that is Dashlit, and I love how easy it is to set up and use and manage. I would love to know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Again, links to everything will be in the video description if you want to check those out. Again, if you've got thoughts, I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you're having issues with the application, again, I can't really help you with that. But there is a spot over on the GitHub repository where you can submit an issue or get some troubleshooting help, that sort of thing. So again, everything linked in the video description. Before we go, I would encourage you, if you feel the urge to like and subscribe to this video, or like this video and subscribe to the channel, I guess is the better way to put that, whatever. You know how this YouTube stuff works at this point. It's all free if you want to like and subscribe. Again, earlier I mentioned Homelab Launchpad. It's a project that I'm getting ready to start deploying some content on for you guys that kind of goes back to the basics of self-hosting. And I would love for you guys to check that out. And of course, the easiest way to do that is to go over and subscribe to that channel if you want to do that. Again, links to everything in the video description. But I think with that said, I'm going to wrap this up. I want to thank you guys for spending a couple of minutes with me here today. And I'll talk to you in the next video.